إن الحمد لله حمدا يليق بجلال وجهه وعظيم سلطانه. اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى، ولك الحمد إذا رضيت، ولك الحمد بعد الرضا. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وقرة أعيننا ونور قلوبنا محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وكرم على عبدك المصطفى سيدنا محمد وعلى آله الأطهار وأصحابه الأخيار ومن تبعهم بإحسان وهدى إلى يوم الدين، وعلينا معهم وفيهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله، إني أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. لا إله إلا الله. واعلم أن خير الدنيا والآخرة في تقوى الله وطاعته، وأن شر الدنيا والآخرة في معصية الله ومخالفته، وأن الساعة آتية لا ريب فيها، وأن الله يبعث من في القبور. All praise belongs to Allah, the glorious and the majestic, the one who sees the outward and the inward, and that which is even more hidden, Jalla Jalalu. We praise him and we bear witness that there is nothing worthy of worship other than Allah, the true God, the creator of the heavens and the earth, the singular, the one, the unique, the most high and majestic, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And we bear witness that our noble and beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam is his final prophet and messenger, who came with the Quran and who came with the embodiment of guidance and goodness and beautiful character, and guided us to every good and warned us of every evil and left us on the clear, straight path that none veer from, except that they bring upon themselves destruction. And we seek Allah, we seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from that. My beloved elders, brothers and sisters and community members, I remind myself and all of you to be mindful of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. That the mindfulness of Allah is something that permeates our every moment. That we need to be people who are seeking to have hearts that are alive and that are witnessing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every moment of stillness, and in every action, and in every intention, and in every word that we speak, and every action that we do. The Prophet ﷺ once was teaching the Sahaba a very valuable lesson. So they were sitting in his masjid, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, and the Prophet ﷺ said, a man from the people of paradise is about to enter the masjid. So there was a man who entered, and the Sahaba noticed him. The next day, the Prophet ﷺ said a second time, a man from the people of paradise is about to enter the masjid, and the same man entered a second time. The next day, the situation occurred a third time. So Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, I need to see what it is that this man has, that the Messenger of Allah salawatullahi wa salam alayhi would tell us 3 days in a row that he's of the people of paradise. So he found an excuse and he asked the man if he could stay with him in his house for a few days because he wanted to observe very carefully. Does he have some very special quality, or what is the quality that he has? So he stayed with him for a few nights and he did not notice anything particularly different or unique outwardly. He did not see that the man fasted a lot. He did not see that he got up particularly early for Qiyam al-Layl. He did not notice anything that was outwardly special. So finally, after the few days, he came to the man and he said, "Listen, I have to tell you why I am here. Is that I saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam testify on your behalf, saying that you are of the people of paradise. And I wanted to know why that is." And the man said, "Honestly, I don't have anything particularly unique, except that every night before I go to sleep, I forgive everyone who has wronged me that day. I forgive everyone who has wronged me and upset me that day, and I go to sleep without any rancor, any anger or hatred in my heart towards any of the Muslims." That was the quality. And that was something, my beloved brothers and sisters, that indicates that although the acts of ibadah are extremely important, what the Prophet ﷺ taught us is that that act of ibadah, it is meant to transform your heart, and it is meant to pierce the rust that seems to make a layer between our heart and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in another hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at your forms, and He does not look at your bodies, but He looks at your hearts and your deeds. That the place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at us is our heart. And this brings us back, when I came the first time about a month ago, that we talked about the three elements for change according to the prophetic model. According to the model of the Prophet Muhammad salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, and those were knowledge, seeking the knowledge that Allah wants from us. And the second was the implementation of that knowledge in a way that purifies our hearts. And then the third, which we will talk about in the next khutbah inshaAllah, is inviting people to their Creator, calling people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this khutbah, we are looking at the purification of the heart. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Al-ihsan an ta'bud Allah ka'annaka tarah, fa'in lam takun tarahu fa'innahu yarak." The excellence in our deen, ihsan, the beautification of your soul, is that you worship Allah as though you see Him. And that if you do not see Him, knowing that He sees you. That this is extremely important in our deen, that the ibadah, prayer, fasting, the recitation of the Qur'an, the outward sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad, they are very important. But what this hadith and many other situations with the Sahaba teach us is all of that is meant to really give us a heart that is transformed. That when we return to our homes and no one else is around us, that our heart is still aware and witnessing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every moment. It is going from the level of ilm al-yaqeen, the knowledge of yaqeen, to ayn al-yaqeen, to haqq al-yaqeen, the reality of certainty. As Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, he said, "لَوْ كُشِفَ الْغِطَامَ ازْدِدْتُ يَقِينًا." If the veil on the akhirah was lifted, I would not increase in yaqeen, because his belief in Allah and the transformation that occurred in his heart was completed. That is the state that we need to be in. That is the state that we need to aspire to. That we are witnessing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ulama, they say that alhamdulillah, the body goes into sujood every day, at least 5 times a day. We prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But they say that all of that is seeking that moment in which your heart goes into prostration. That your heart makes sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they say, when the heart makes sujood, it never comes out of sujood. That we be in a state of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That we be people who have beautiful character, the character of the Prophet Muhammad salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. That our ibadah, it pierces into our heart and transforms our heart. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, he emphasized this time and time and time again. He said, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, ala inna fil jasadi mudgha, that there is a morsel of flesh in the body. And this is an indication of the spiritual meaning behind that. Idha saluhat salah al jasadu kullu, if this part of you is rectified, if it is made right, the rest of your body will be made right. And if it is corrupted, the rest of your body will be made corrupted. And he said, أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبِ. Truly it is the heart. If the heart is purified, if the heart increases in the beautiful qualities of belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of trusting in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of patience, of gratitude, of certainty, of yearning and loving Allah and His Messenger salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, and it is cleansed of the lowly qualities of arrogance and envy and hatred, then the rest of your body will be rectified. Your salah will become alive. Your siyam will become alive. Your recitation of the Quran will soften your heart. Like Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, he would say, if the hearts were purified, they would never become bored of reciting the Qur'an. They would continue to taste the sweetness. This is what we are called to in our deen. This is something that each and every one of us should have an aspiration towards. Someone might say, you know, we see people praying all of the time, but they still have bad character. And Allah says in the Qur'an, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ, that the prayer prevents one from falling into vile and corrupt acts. So how does that add up? The reason being is that the salah has not reached their heart. The form of the salah is one thing, but the reality of the salah, as one of the salihin, he said, when I enter into the prayer, I only see the judgment before me, paradise on my right and the hellfire on my left. So how can I think about anything else other than the prayer in that moment? And you see this in the state of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum time and time again. Why is that? It is because Allah and His Messenger brought their hearts to life. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِسْتَجِيبُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلْرَسُولِ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ. O you who believe, respond to Allah and His Messenger when they call you to that which gives you life. The life of the soul, the life of the heart. And the way that we express that, and one of the greatest criteria that we have regarding that is beautiful akhlaq. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. Truly, I was sent to perfect noble character. That we have akhlaq, we have character in our dealings with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fulfilling His rights, being in awe of His majesty, hoping for His reward, fearful of His punishment. And we also have a relationship with His creation, that we smile at one another, we honor our parents, we honor our elders, we take care of the poor and the sick, and we are concerned for their needs. That we treat everyone with beautiful character and honor and respect. These are the akhlaq that indicate the goodness of the heart and the transformation of the heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala desires from us in this deen. And this is ihsan. And this is focusing on that element that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said time and time again, التقوى هاهنا, التقوى هاهنا, التقوى هاهنا. That mindfulness of Allah is here. Once again, this doesn't mean that the outward does not matter. أعوذ بالله. We have a sharia that guides all of our actions. But that it is not, we are not surface level people. We do not suffice ourselves with just establishing the forms, but we are people that when we experience the ibadah, we want the deepest levels of nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would say to Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu anhu, and if we're honest with ourselves, and I'm not putting anyone down, I'm reminding myself as well. If we're honest with ourselves, we feel oftentimes a heaviness. Oh, we have to pray, we have so much to do. But when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba, they would pray, the Prophet would say, arihna biha ya Bilal. Oh Bilal, give us our comfort. Bring us our comfort, when he would tell him to make the adhan. And that they would get up for qiyam al-layl willingly. That they would give their wealth in the sake of Allah, willing, happily. That these things were not chores upon them. Why? Because they were able in their attachment and the rearing and the teaching of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were able to rid themselves of the rust that develops around the heart, and to have luminous and beautiful hearts that were near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is what we are seeking, and this is one of the things that we truly need in our ummah. That we need that knowledge that we mentioned last time. We need to know fard ayn. We need to know what it is that we believe about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the six pillars of iman. We need to establish the fara'id of wudu and salah and the hajj and the siyam and avoiding the haram and so forth. And then we also, in addition to that knowledge, we need to implement it. We need to recognize that this revelation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us is really to give us an elevated station with Him, Jalla Jalalu. As Imam al-Shafi'i would say, rahmatullah alayh, أَنْتَ بِالْرُوحِ لَا بِالْجِسْمِ إِنسَانُ. You are by your soul, not your body, a human being. When Allah says, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ, we have honored humanity, we have honored the children of Adam alayhi salam. How? Not in this flesh and blood. This is going to go. We will leave this behind. But what remains? Our soul. What remains? Whatever we put forward in our relationship with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, that is what we will find on Yawm al-Qiyamah. And whatever we did sincerely. This is another element of the purification of the heart, is that it must be sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Free of showing off, free of any other blameworthy qualities that are not pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the path of ihsan. This is the path of tazkiyah, of beautifying our hearts and beautifying our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu yaqulu wa qawluhu al-haqqul mubin. وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. وَقَالَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى فَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the translation of which is, O believers, be mindful of Allah and speak in a direct fashion and to good purpose. And He will put your deeds right for you and forgive you your sins. Whoever obeys God and His Messenger will truly achieve a great triumph. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'na bima fihi min al-ayat wa al-dhikr al-hakim wa ajarana min khizihi wa adabihi al-alim. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-Azim li wa lakum wa li walidina wa li jami' al-muslimin. Fastaghfiruhu innahu huwa al-ghafur al-rahim. Seek Allah's forgiveness, indeed He is forgiving and merciful. إن الحمد لله حمدا يليق بجلال وجهه وعظيم سلطانه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك وكرم على عبدك المصطفى سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله، إني أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. لا إله إلا الله. To give everyone a practical takeaway. Sometimes this topic, it can be heavy, and it can even for some people seem a little bit abstract. A very simple takeaway is that every single one of us in our homes, with our children, whether we're commuting to work and we're listening to something of benefit, every single one of us should study deeply and continuously review the akhlaq of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, was sent as a mercy to all the worlds. And the Sahaba, radwanullahi ta'ala alayhim, they would say, خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّأً مِنْ كُلِّ عَيْبٍ كَأَنَّكَ قَدْ خُلِقْتَ كَمَا تَشَاءُ. About the Prophet, they would say lines of poetry, you were created free of any kind of flaw, as if you were created as just as you wanted to be. That the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they saw every goodness from him. And he was the first to practice what he preached, and he was the fountainhead, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, of every good quality, of mercy, of generosity, of patience, of forbearance. So the way that we are able to attain that purity of heart is by connecting to him, inwardly and outwardly. That the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the sunnah of what he did, but then there is also the sunnah of how he was, and his state, and the state of his heart, and his character. The fact that he, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, he would stand up at night praying for creation and praying for his ummah, that Allah guide them and not punish them for their sins. That he would forgive those who wronged him, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. That he was loving and patient with his wives and with children. That he never raised his voice against a woman and never hit a woman, let alone any one of his wives, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the akhlaq of the Prophet Muhammad. And this is something that we need every single day and on a regular basis. And this is the nourishment of the hearts. This is what helps us remove that rust so that we can draw closer to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And that the way that we do that is by following his beloved, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all tawfiq. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with beautiful hearts, and hearts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala places his light, the light of iman and the light of hidayah, into our hearts. And that light shines into the hearts of our brothers and sisters in humanity so that they are guided. Our brothers and sisters in humanity so that they can find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our brothers and sisters in humanity so that they can have the path that helps them heal from all the difficulties of the dunya and all the difficulties that come with misguidance. That we have a clear and bright luminous lamp in the example of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that nourishes us, that strengthens us, and that guides us through the trials and tribulations of the life of this world. Wallahu bada'a, inna Allah bada'a bi amrin bada'a fihi bi nafsih, wa thanna bil malaikati musabbahati bi qudsih, wa wajaha bil mu'minina ta'meema, faqala mukhbiran wa amiran lahum takreeman wa ta'zeema, inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وكرم على عبدك المصطفى سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا في مقامنا هذا إلا غفرته، ولا همّا إلا فرجته، ولا حاجة هي لك رضاء إلا قضيتها يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها، أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة، إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابُ. Oh Allah, we ask you, O most merciful, that you purify our hearts and that you beautify our state with you. Ya Akram al-Akramin. We ask you, Ya Allah, that the love of you and the love of your beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are more beloved to us than everything else. Ya Arham al-Rahimin. We ask you, Ya Allah, that you give us presence of heart in our prayer. We ask you, Ya Allah, that you beautify us with the beautiful character of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask you, Ya Allah, that you protect our homes and our families and our wives and our husbands and our children. And we ask you, Ya Allah, that you create love and mercy in our homes. And we ask you, Ya Allah, that you solidify and strengthen the iman in our hearts and in the hearts of our children and the next generation of Muslims. Ya Arham al-Rahimin. We ask you, Ya Allah, that you give us a living Islam. We ask you, Ya Allah, that we experience the sweetness of iman. Ya Arham al-Rahimin. We ask you, Ya Allah, that you guide our brothers and sisters in creation to you. Ya Arham al-Rahimin. And you are the most merciful and you are full of compassion for your creation. We ask you, Ya Allah, that you bestow them with guidance. Ya Akram al-Akramin. We ask you, Ya Allah, that you teach us that which benefits us, and you benefit us with what we have learned, and that you make us lights of guidance for others. Ya Arham al-Rahimin. We ask you, Ya Allah, that you allow each and every one of us to die upon La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, realized in its realities and dying upon its trueness and resurrected upon that, and that we meet you with that. Ya Arham al-Rahimin. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Inna Allah ya'muru bil'adli wal-ihsan وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر. أقم الصلاة.